Animated movies create the impression that characters are moving smoothly. But if you slow them down enough, you'll realize there are lots of individual images. Each image is just a little bit different from the one before. Speed them back up, and your eyes are tricked into thinking you're watching real-life motion. A very simple example of this effect is a flipbook. The key to animation, whether on paper or the computer, is that part of the drawing is changing over time. An easy way to achieve a change is to use the random number command to generate a new random location, size, or color for the shape we're drawing. Here's a simple program that draws a single rectangle with a random X position and a random Y position. If we run and reset this program over and over again, we can see that it draws the rectangle in a new position each time. But that's like a flipbook with only one page. To create real animations, we need to be able to string these pages of the flipbook together. In GameLab, we'll do this using the draw function. The draw function is special in GameLab. The commands inside of the draw function are run line by line from top to bottom. But once the computer reaches the end of the commands inside the draw function, it jumps back to the beginning and repeats the commands over and over again, as long as your program is running. Because the code in the draw function repeats in a loop, we'll just refer to this as the draw loop. Let's move our rectangle inside the draw loop and see what happens. Whoa, so many rectangles! We can see that a rectangle isn't just being drawn once anymore. GameLab is automatically calling the commands inside of the draw loop many times a second. In this program, that means that a new random X and Y location is generated, and then a rectangle is drawn over and over and over. You can place as many commands as you like inside of the draw function. For example, let's choose a new fill color before drawing each rectangle by placing a fill command inside the draw loop. Instead of always choosing the same color, we'll randomize by replacing the red value with the random number command. So in every frame of the flipbook, the computer is picking a new shade of red and setting that as the fill color. Then it picks a new X and Y value and draws a rectangle with those values. In a typical animated movie or flipbook, you don't continue to see all of the drawings that came earlier in the animation. Instead, you have the illusion of a single shape or character moving over time. You'll discover how to make that happen with the draw loop soon.